I was born and raised in Greece. My parents were Gypsy missionaries, and so they adopted two older Gypsy brothers, and I grew up with them, plus my older sister and a late younger sister. So we were a family of seven, and my dad's Gypsy ministry for about 25 years. Hello, I'm Pastor Pavlos Son, and my Korean name is Joo Young Son, and I will tell you a little bit about me and my testimony. Gypsies were a people without a nation. They are all over Europe, mostly in the warmer climates, and they live by selling metals and selling flowers, washing windows on the traffic lights, and they usually try to make a living as the poorest people in society. And they are usually illiterate, and they have families with a lot of children. Our close group of ours was a family of 12 children, and so we would visit them often and be able to care for them and their needs. And my dad also planted a church for the Gypsies. And so I grew up as a missionary's kid, and that means that I got to know about God and the Bible from a very young age. And I can say that my role model was Jesus and all the Bible characters in the story of the Bible. And as I was growing up with these role models, my goal was to be a good person. But I wanted to do that with my own strength, with my own wisdom. And thankfully, in my middle school years, during a missionary kids retreat in Korea in 2005, I got to meet Christ personally. And for the first time, it was not simply my parents' God, but it was my personal God. It was not just them and their sins that he was on the cross for, but he was actually my Savior, the one who died for my sins. I could realize that I was a sinner and that I truly needed a Savior and that I could not save myself. And I got to know Christ as that sweet Redeemer who is able to forgive me, who is able to renew me and give me a new heart that I can truly love God. And so my testimony is not that I was a crazy drug dealer and then I became a Christian. My testimony was I tried to be good with my own strength, but then I found out that I needed Christ, and only through Christ I can be a child of God and truly love God and love neighbors. And so as I grew up, I experienced various difficulties such as racial discrimination. During my high school years, there was a group of students, five to be specific, that used to bully me and try to get me ostracized out of their group. And thankfully, I was already in Christ. My confidence and my identity was rooted in the gospel. And so I did not waver. And I was actually reading the book of James during that time. And it talked about the wisdom of being able to tame your tongue, the wisdom of being able to not retaliate, fight evil for evil, but do good despite of evil and trust God. And so my goal was, no matter how much they mistreated me, that I would be kind to them, that I would speak gently with them. And even though it was difficult, I knew that that's what God wanted me to do, and I tried to persevere in being obedient. And about 6 months later, one of the people that was the most hateful towards me approached me in anger and said, you know, we are treating you like crap. Why are you not doing the same to us? And he was actually moved, and I was able to share why it is that I behave the way that I do and why it is that I'm not going to act in the same way that they are treating me, or treat them in the same way that they are treating me. And even though he did not become a Christian, I can say that we did become good friends, and he was able to appreciate where I stood and how I held my ground based on what I believe. And another thing that I learned as I was in Korea during third grade and in Korea during eighth grade, during my parents' sabbatical. Once every 4 years, my parents were able to stay in Korea and I got to experience the Korean culture and go back to Greece. And during all those different cultural encounters, I was able to learn to adapt in any environment. I think this was one of the gifts that God gave me throughout my experience, as he taught me how to depend on him and rely on him and know that as long as he is with me, anywhere and any new encounter or culture is going to be good and sufficient, because he will be my God, he will be my provider. And so I was definitely blessed by having my identity rooted in Christ. And if there is any encouragement I can give you in your youth, it would be that you would be certain of your faith and that you would let your faith be the central and guiding factor of how you are to understand life, how you are to approach life, and knowing that as long as Christ is with you, which He is, then you will have no difficulties or troubles which you cannot overcome in Christ Jesus. And so I hope that you will truly come to know this Christ, this Savior that I got to know and have as my personal Savior. And I hope that your testimony would be also one where you get to glorify God in all the life encounters that He has given you. Currently, I am the youth group pastor for NYPC, and I am serving as a part-time pastor here. And I really appreciate spending time with youth group students and teaching them about Christ and how He can be the life-altering point in your life, that He can be the one who can truly set you free from your sins and from all the temptations and enable you to walk as a child of God. And so I hope that you will be also encouraged and instructed to continue to know Christ and continue to grow in Christ as you get to live every day. Thank you for your time, and God bless you.